2020 has not been a year of grand celebration. The global pandemic closed businesses, canceled social gatherings, and flooded the world with stories of loss. Starting in March, people weren't just scared for their physical health. They were also concerned for their mental health. Feelings of guilt, loneliness, and fear can make a serious impact on a person's ability to feel hopeful and happy. If this sounds like you, you're not alone. An online therapy provider called Talkspace saw a 65% increase in clients since mid-February. Emergency hotlines are experiencing severely high call volumes, but is it time for you to seek help? Are you simply going through routine ups and downs, or could your feelings be a symptom of a more serious mood disorder? I'm not a psychiatrist, nor am I a medical professional, but I have a tool for you to begin assessing your own mental health and whether or not you may be experiencing depressive symptoms. This tool, the Beck Depression Inventory, is one of the top tools used to assess a person's mental health and determine whether they are experiencing depression. So the Beck Depression Inventory was first published in 1961. It was created by Aaron T. Beck, one of the pioneers of something called cognitive behavioral therapy. The Beck Depression Inventory, as well as the Beck Hopelessness Scale, the Beck Anxiety Inventory, and as well as a few other tools that cognitive behavioral therapists use in their practices. The Beck Depression Inventory marked a significant shift in the way that therapists assess someone for mood disorders, as well as recognizing the cause of those disorders. But before Beck came along, psychoanalysis was at the forefront of psychology. Sigmund Freud believed that mood disorders and other symptoms were a result of trauma and experiences found in a person's unconscious mind. He thought all of these negative behaviors could point back to the unconscious mind. A therapist would use things like word association, dream interpretations, and a few other kind of weird methods to uncover what was hiding in the unconscious. By unpacking these experiences, the patient may be cured of the mood disorder, and they would no longer think negatively about themselves or the world. However, Beck had a different theory as to what caused these symptoms of depression and other mood disorders. He didn't believe that the mood disorders caused someone to think bad things. He believed it was the other way around, that people had bad thoughts that eventually caused the mood disorders. For example, let's say someone were to begin thinking, "I've made so many mistakes in my life." They think it over and over, and every time they encounter an opportunity, they think to themselves, "I'll just make another mistake." Beck believed that these thought patterns eventually led to depression. This was revolutionary at the time. Therapists began to replace psychoanalysis with cognitive behavioral therapy. Instead of unpacking a patient's dreams, they would discover how the patient was actually talking to themselves. They would look at the ways that the patient perceives certain situations and how the patient reflects on their past experiences. Using this information, they can make diagnosis, offer tools, and show a patient how their negative thoughts were actually causing negative moods and their symptoms. So if you go to a therapist today, you'll very likely go through a similar experience, and you can thank Aaron T. Beck. Moving on, the current version of the Beck Depression Inventory is similar to the original version created in 1961, but it has undergone some changes. New versions of the BDI were published in both 1978 and 1996, and experts recommend this tool primarily for adolescents over the age of 13, but it can also be used to assess an adult's feelings and potential mood disorder. Now, all versions are a self-assessment quiz with 21 questions. Each question consists of 4 statements. And each one of those statements corresponds with a number from 0 to 3. So here's an example of one of the questions. 0. I am not particularly discouraged about the future. 1. I feel discouraged about the future. 2. I feel I have nothing to look forward to. And 3. I feel the future is hopeless and that things cannot improve. When you're taking this test, all you do is keep track of your answers and add them up at the end. The results will put you kind of in a category. If you score 1 to 10, you're in normal ups and downs. 11 through 16, you have a mild mood disturbance. 17 to 20, you may have borderline clinical depression. 21 through 30 scores moderate depression. 31 through 40 is severe depression. And anything above 40 is extreme depression. Now, there's really no need to take this test again and again throughout the week, because even if you're going through the general ups and downs, you will likely get the same answer if you take the test the next day or the day after. I also want to say that the Beck Depression Inventory has been considered extremely reliable, even after it has been translated and distributed throughout the world. But now it comes to the question, what do we do with your score? Because your score might surprise you. It might also reveal something to you that you may have been thinking but were too nervous to admit. And if your score suggests that you're moderately or severely depressed, do not feel guilty asking for help. Do not feel ashamed. The state of the world, the pressure to isolate, and the general stress can have some serious effects. You should know you're not weak for feeling hopeless, pessimistic, or sad during these times. There are many ways to seek treatment for depression and other mood disorders. You can search online for a therapist near you. Recently, I actually reached out to a therapist on Thumbtack and had a great experience. You can use an app like BetterHelp or Talkspace to reach a professional without leaving your home. And if you prefer to be in a group setting, you can actually consider looking up support groups in your area. So in short, what do you do with your score? Your score is supposed to help you if you may be experiencing some form of depression, but aren't able to currently identify that you actually may be experiencing depression. It's a tool to help you seek help if you don't think you need help. And in the meantime, take a look at your routine. Are you exercising? Are you taking time to connect with friends and family? And do you have enough time to read, write, or maybe indulge in whatever hobbies you enjoy? Small changes to your daily routine can and should help you enjoy the day just a little bit more. Thank you guys so much for watching this video. I want to let you know I've recently developed an actual online version of Beck's Depression Inventory. You can take it completely free. It takes around 5 minutes to complete on my very own website. You can click the link in the description below to check it out. If you have any questions at all, feel free to leave a comment below, and I'll see you in the next video.